Is that why you're
not too happy with that?
Yeah, I know. Oh, stay. Nice.
What's up, everyone? It's crazy how many days end up like this, where I'm with a big group of people, a bunch on Donek's. We got Sky, Andy, Adam, Juan, Cheryl,
yep.
And Garrett. And ripping some carving. First tip, when you're with a big group of carvers, let leave everyone plenty of space. You don't want people questioning their own turns because you're too close to them. So plenty of space gives a wide margin of error. And then just looking for those uphill skiers, of course, because so many people just bomb straight down here because they can't turn on that steeper skidded off terrain. And then where we're carving up on the flatter part where it's really good snow, it can be sketchy if we're not looking around. So one of the things we were talking about earlier was apex of the turn and making that our highest edge angle. What do most people do with what? Where's their most people's highest edge angle, Andy?
I think the highest edge angle should be right at the apex or just after it, because that's where the most force in the turn is going to be.
I like that too. If we're thinking about it in terms of circles, it's kind of pushing outwards. So how do we push a circle out? Kind of, you got to get your mass going across the run, really finishing that previous turn. That will set you up for that next one. Sky, what are your tips?
Yeah, I think just to extend your legs in the middle of the turn to resist the pressure and to absorb it at the edge change.
That is my favorite style of, especially on the heel side carves, really pushing. And again, we're on super wide boards, so we can extend our legs and not be booting out yet. So if you're on narrower boards, you might purposely need to keep a lower edge angle, less tilt. So if you start booting out at about that angle, purposely bring it down to about there. If you're not booting out, play with how much you can tilt that board and still have your edge engaged, because that's the important part of the carve. So let's see, where's your boot out phase? At what angle?
Over here.
So he can almost get to 90 degrees, but again, once we're carving, the track might leave. Yep, Andy's on a narrower one, so about that angle. And it's actually going to be a less angle than that, right? Because once we're carving, we're leaving a track about that deep, so then the bindings will hit earlier too. But it's a beautiful thought, just highest edge angle at the apex of the turns. Be patient with your turns like that and just anticipate those high edge angles at the apex. Beautiful thoughts. I just love thinking about it. All right, let's make some turns.
Of course, one of these days I'll get out here on a decent board.
Nice.
Woo. Oh, he faked me out.
Yeah, bud. Andy with the header tripod. Andy, how old are you now?
51.
And with thinking about apex of the turns, where do you think I like taking off on my buttering tricks? Not late, not too late in the turn, not too early. Apex. Not super high edge angle either, just medium. Got a super high edge angle butter, and yeah, funky things can happen. Got to slow down if you want to go into like tripods and stuff. But Sky, would you do some front side nose rolls? I've never taped some of yours.
Oh yeah.
It is no fun when that shit happens. Oof, duh. What a nice day shredding with both new and old friends and enjoying these awful views. It's finally gotten a little less busy out at Breck. That's why I don't tape often. When it's too busy, it just gets too sketchy, too dangerous for actual real carving, and other than early in the mornings. But once it gets busy, just navigating through too many people, too much traffic causes sketchy situations. To all my Ukrainian friends, I wish you all the best. I've been getting a bunch of messages from y'all lately, and yeah, I don't know what to say other than I'm sorry we live in such a goofy world. Nationals demo info. If you can make it to Copper Mountain, April 1st to April 7th, if you want to try Donek snowboards out, experience different board models, specs, length, width, side cut radiuses, all that. Join us over at Copper Mountain. It's always a good time. Conditions, you know, springtime conditions usually. Sometimes in the morning it's icy. Sometimes it's perfect snow. So, but yeah, it's usually pretty great spring ski in there. So, hope to see you there. Let me know in the comments if you are going to make it. I bet we'll add some more demo boards yet. So, yep. Thank you all for watching. Happy shredding. Wish you all the best.